Yes, so we were discussing lookup and references last time. So let's see some of the formulas here. In VLOOKUP, there is one another concept. Like we have seen the usage of false in the last parameter, but today we will see the use with true parameter. In VLOOKUP, when we type VLOOKUP, so there is a range lookup in which we always supply false, but there is a condition where we can supply true for approximate match. So let's say we have
approximate match, okay.
Name and sales. I type some sales here. Let me remove my name. Let's see, we have some sales figure and we want to distribute incentive. Okay. So for 0 to 40, I want to give the incentive. Let's say it is quantity. So for 0 to 40 quantity sales, I want to give them incentive of $500. Then 41 to 60, I want to give them 1000. 61 to 80, I want to give them 1500. Then greater than 80, I will give them 2000. So if I design this type of condition with if formula, so it will be very long. Okay. With if formula, it will be quite difficult to develop. So for that case, we have here two formulas for approximate match, but we have to type in other direction. Like 40, I am typing here 500. The next breakpoint is 60, 1000. Then 80. No, we will start from zero, from the starting point.
So, what does the INC stand for?
Incentive. Commission.
Oh, incentive, okay. Okay, okay.
So, we will design this type of data here. Why we are designing, let's see example first, then we get to know. We will type VLOOKUP. The lookup value will be this quantity and the table array will be this table. I am locking it. Then column index is, this is second, and then we have to use true or one. So it's a very easy formula. Let's suppose you see 0 to 40 it is 500, 40 to 60 it is 1000, 60 to 80 it is 1500, 60 to 80 this one, then greater than 80 it is 2000. So it's a very easy formula you can use for this purpose rather than a formula. One more formula you have for this purpose, lookup. Not VLOOKUP, only lookup. So you have lookup value, lookup vector. In lookup vector, you give the lookup ID column. Okay. Then you need to choose the result vector. Okay. This lookup formula by default behave like in VLOOKUP we use true for exact approximate match it behaves. Okay, so you can see the same result here. Okay. So you got the basic idea what it is doing. Let's suppose yes. For 76, it is searching in this data. If 76 is not there, it is searching the below range, because in 80 it is 2000. So between 80 to 60 it is searching the approximate nearest match it is finding. Okay.
Okay.
That is the whole idea between VLOOKUP or true and lookup.
Then how come the quantity from, so I got a question, for the quantity, you got 0 to 40, how come the 0 has the apostrophe on it?
That I had fixed. Okay. This is the main data actually. That is for understanding purpose only. I have written like this. Okay. Now let's move to another function. Which is offset. It is like index. So as I told you, row and column, I will type here. So as I told you, the index formula does what? Index formula, you need to choose an array. We have chosen a single, they are in index match, single array, but we can choose multiple data also. In that condition, you have to give row number and column number. Okay. So row number, column number we will choose from here. And so there is no value, that means there is zero. So if we choose one first row and first column, so it will give me the first value of this data. Okay. Second row, in second row this one and the first column. Okay, so we can change the column and get the value. Second row and third column, so this is second row and 1, 2, 3, this is the third column. Okay, the same value we can see. But in case of offset, index start counting from 1 to 3, but offset start counting from 0, 1 to 3. Okay. In index, you have to choose whole formula, whole data, but in offset, you have to give the just starting point. So if I give the starting point this one, then row column I can choose from here, row n column. So in case of offset, if we go to second row, that means this is 0 position, 1, 2. It will go on third row for second. Then third column, so 0 column is this one, then 1, 2, 3. So this value will be shown here. Okay. So this is the basic difference between index and offset function. Both you, with match you can try offset also, but you have to choose the reference above, or you have to do minus 1 for that. Okay, so it is one more thing we can do with offset. We have got one value here, only one value, 49, but there is a concept of height and width. So in height and width, we can choose height and width from here. So if we choose 1, 1, offset, take the reference from here, row, column, height and width. So it will show you the same value, but when we increase the height to 2, it will give you some error. But if you select the area and press F2 and Control Shift Enter, so it will give you some data. Okay. So there are two values it is showing. For better understanding, let's put this value under sum function. Sum function. So whatever value offset is getting, it will sum. And you have to choose Control Shift Enter. So what it is doing, I am talking about 2 height and 1 width. So that means it will come first row column, so second row, 1, 2, second row, then third column, 1, 2, 3, this. Then when we talk about height, so it will increase the height, this one. As you can see, the height is 2 cells and width is 1 cell. So you can see the sum value here also in status bar. If I increase the width to 2, so that means from here 2 cells down, 2 cells right, so it will cover the 2 cells now in width and in height. So the total is 183, as you can see here and here also. Okay, so it can grab the data, some selected data from your data as you want. So this extra function the offset do, then we will more clear the offset function in our dashboard section. The one there we will need this offset function. Okay. In charts also it is used offset, because when you are it is giving some data like this, so we can use for our chart columns also, chart data. From a particular data we can dynamically choose the data by this offset function, by increasing and decreasing width. So it is useful in offset function also, in chart also. So I think that is all about this lookup and references. Then let's take example of some of the financial formulas. Okay. For financial formula,
okay,
we have some terms here, PV, FV, that means present value. Future value of the fund, rate is used for rate of interest, it is monthly, then for time.
I'm having some problems, Sandeep. I'm having some problems seeing your screen. It looks like it's not updating. You're typing, right? You're typing, but the screen doesn't seem to be updating.
I guess net connection is getting slower. That's why this problem occurs. Let me check with me.
I can hear you type, but I don't see any changes on the screen.
Okay.
Okay, now I can see it. Yeah.
You can see it?
Yeah, now I can see it. Now I can, yeah.
Now exit.
Yeah, now I don't see anything. RA? I just see a RA.
Rate. Excel is not updating.
Okay, now got rate of interest monthly.
Rate of interest monthly. Then we have PAR for time, duration. Okay. This is duration which is accepted in year. No, it is also in months. So, these are the terms we will use here. Present value for the fund, future value, rate of interest and duration. Then, so here we have financial formula. And PMT for per month installation, yeah, or EMI you can say. So first function we have PV, present value. Let's suppose we have FV 50,000. Okay. Then we have a rate of 14%. Then we have time for 5 years. Okay. And what will be the present value of this fund? So it will be, we will use PV formula for present value. So we will giving rate here. So rate, it is yearly. Okay. Rate 14% we have chosen yearly. So we have to convert in monthly. So I will do divide by 12. Okay. Then N per. The time is year, 5 years. So I will multiply in month. So 5 multiplied by 12. Then we have two options, FP, P, either we can give PMT or we can give FP. So PMT I will give 0, then FV I will give from here 50,000. So the present value of the funds is 24,930. Okay. Likewise. Let's suppose we have PV 50,000. rate 14% time 5 years. Now we want to know the FE. We can use the FE formula. Same condition, rate multiplied by 12. N bar is your time multiplied by well, then PMT we will put 0 here, then PV we have, this one 50,000. So total will value will for the funds will be 1 lakh. Okay, after 5 years. Now we want to know the per month installation for that. Rate divided by 12, time multiplied by 12, then PV. Yeah, we have FV, so we will give 0 here in PV, and by comma we will give FV. So we will give, we will get the PMT, EMIs. For the present value we will get the PMT, rate is multiplied by, divided by 12, time is multiplied by 12. Then PV we have here, so this will be the PMT, per month installation for that. One more thing, financial formula returns the result in negative. So it is shown in red, you can see. It is always, it will show the value in negative always. So if you want to do it positive, you can use ABS function, which converts any negative number into positive number. Okay, basically we can do it by, then let's suppose we have what if we have PMT and everything, we can know that what is the time is, rate is. So we have rate formula to know the rate of interest. So rate n per is time is multiplied by 12, then we have PMT here, then we have PV here. Okay. So it is showing you 1%, but you have to multiply it because it gives you the monthly interest. So you have to multiply with 12, then you will get the actual value. Okay. Likewise, you have time. Time N per formula. Okay, to know the time. So rate multiplied by 12, then PMT. Rate will be divided by 12. PMT we have here, or PV, or FV. Whatever we want to choose, we can choose from. So we will take PMT here, then we will choose PV here. Okay. So we will know the term, it is 60 N per returning because it is giving you the monthly timing. So number of months, so we will divide by 12, so we can get to know the timings in a year. Okay. This is N per form. Now for loan, like PV is mostly used for your loan section. Okay, that you have taken 50 loan of 50,000 rupees for the rate of 14% and for 5 years, so your payment will be this one monthly. So with including of interest. So banks calculate the charges monthly, and with this they use file charge and insurance charge, other charges. So if you know those charges, you can calculate, you can use this formula to track your loan status. That's how the bank calculate. Now we have taken this much of loan, PV 50,000, and now we want to know that how this PMT, is it correct or not. So we will make a data here. First we will type PER, which means the number of payment we will be making, because they are giving the flat 14%, that how bank is going to calculate the things. So I am just dragging to it to 60, because I will make 60 payments. So this is 60. Then I will, what is the base payment, means principal. I want to see in my installment how much I am giving principal and how much I am giving interest. Then total I will make here, which will be your EMI per month. So it is 1163. So for calculating principal, we have PPMT. Okay. Same thing we will use, rate divided by 12. This PER means the period in which you are giving the payment to bank. So this one, okay. So I just log it, log the column. Here I will log all data. Then N per means total time, so it is multiplied by 12. Then we have PV. Okay. So we have PPMT and IPMT. So parameter will be same, the PPMT will be, for interest we have IPMT. So this much of amount I am giving to bank as a principal, as a interest. So let me total it. So it is the same amount which is given by PMT. Okay. Now see the difference of the payment amounts. So you can see in your first installment, you are giving the maximum of interest. Then principal amount is increasing and interest is reducing here. So that's why if you see in last, so you are giving the in your last installment, you are giving maximum of principal and less of interest. And if you want to sum these values, we will use sum formula. So this is 50,000. This is the value with interest. This is your interest part, total interest. And this is your principal amount. Okay. I hope you understood about it.
Yeah. I understand the gist of it.
So Now, let's suppose if I want to know that how much interest I am going to pay in total time. So, I need to do these type of calculation first. Let's say I am taking 20 years. So, I need to drag it down to 240 rows. Then I will get this data. So, we have a formula. We can use an array formula for that. Okay, for evaluating interest, because there is no formula, no fixed formula for this IPMT for getting the total interest. So we will use the same formula but with something like this. I will use sum and the whole formula I will copy here. In this whole formula, what I am going to change is, I am giving the period here. So for period, I will use a formula here. Row 1 colon 60. Okay, for because 5 years, so I need to give it to 60. If I am going to take for 10 years, so 120 I will take. Then what I will do, control shift enter, so you can get the whole data here. How it is working, let me show you. In formula bar I have this one function, evaluate formula, that will show you that how your formula is calculated. In evaluate formula you can see, if you choose evaluate, so it getting you the rate of interest dividing by 12, and you will get this one value. This row 1 to 60, what it does, it will type in array 1 to 60 numbers. Okay, then this data which was generated 5 to 12, 60, then this formula, this IPMT formula, when we evaluate it, so it will give you the same results here in some formula. Like offset formula were giving multiple rows, so I have transferred into some formula. So that kind of data is also we can see here. So this whole data is under some function now. Okay. So array is basically, array is not a formula, array is a concept of applying formula, and array formula gives you multiple cell result into one, but you can show with one cell only. So that's why we will we are using this sum function, or for getting multiple values in same cell. So this is a formula, array formula, it applies to multiple cells at once. Like if you want to know about we will start this formula with equal to, then we have curly braces for array formula. And I am typing 1, 2, 3, 4 here. And I am pressing enter. So it will give me the first value. But when I select the 4 cell and pressing F2 and giving control shift enter, so it will distribute these values. Okay. So what is basically doing, if we type same thing in 1, 2, 3, 4 and choosing down the rows, so I press control shift enter, nothing happened. If I press control shift enter now, so basically what it is doing, it is increasing in columns only, not in the rows. If you want increment in rows, distribution in rows, we have to change some signs. Like, in place of comma, we will use semicolon. Okay. Now what, we will select column, press F2, Control Shift Enter. So you can see it is moving now in rows. F2, Control Shift Enter. So it is moving towards row now. So if I change some data here, I can use both of them. Like, first it should go 1, 2. Then in second row 3, 4. So when I type Control Shift Enter, so data will be represented like this. So this is basically how we deal with array formula. So if you want like this type of formula, this type of values, we can use with VLOOKUP also for the sake of distribution, because when like there are this data, taking some of the cells here. So in one go, if I have to apply VLOOKUP, what we will do? VLOOKUP, lookup value, lookup array, and I have to lock it first. Then we provide column index. In place of column index, I will give some values which will be distributed throughout this. So I will type, I need second column, third column, fourth column, fifth column, and sixth column. Then false or zero. So what I will do, I will select all data, F2, Control Shift Enter. Control Shift Enter for the single row only. Control Shift Enter, because I am distributing in rows. Control Shift Enter. So you can see the same data here without any change of formula. Then we can drag it or copy paste. What is the advantage of array formula? You can't change in between the formula. If you want to type it, you cannot change a part of an array. Without selecting the whole data, you can't change. If you have to delete, you have to select and then delete or change. Because the array formula does not apply on single cell only. So you can't change on single cell this type of data. Okay. So this is very less knowledge about array formula. In my further classes, I will explain more it to you. Tomorrow we will do pivot tables. Okay.
Okay.
So I am stopping this session for today. Tomorrow we will do pivot tables at length.
Okay, thank you.
Okay.
Okay, I'll see you tomorrow.
What?